Hi everyone, so welcome to Medical Microbiology. So today we will continue chapter 5, Survey of Eukaryotic Microorganism. We have lecture number 4 today, which is about protists. Okay, so we just finished lecture on fungi. On the previous lecture, now we will discuss about protists, which is algae and protozoa. So they are under the kingdom of protists. Okay, again, algae and protozoa. So algae, okay, they are many of them or most of them are photosynthetic organisms or they are autotrophic organisms. Okay, remember, they are able to make their own food. So auto means self, trophic means food. So they're able to make their own food. Therefore, most of the algae will be free living. They do not cause problem to human, except several algae, and they are called as an opportunistic parasite or opportunistic pathogen. They only cause disease when they enter into our body, maybe accidentally. For example, if we drink the contaminated water, or if we swim in the lake, drink the lake water, and there are maybe some algae that can cause problem into our body, mostly GI tract problem. Okay, so again, algae, mostly they are free living because they are able to make their own food. Now, different with protozoa, okay, some of them are free living, but some of them also can cause disease because these protozoa, remember, they are heterotrophic. Okay, so they have to get the nutrient from others. So they can enter our body and then they can cause problem. They become parasites inside our body. Example is malaria. Malaria is the parasite that caused by protozoa, and this is number one infectious disease that causing death worldwide. Okay, we start with algae. Again, algae, it is photosynthetic organism. They able to make their own food, therefore they are also known as autotrophic organism. They are able to make their own food because what? Because they have chloroplast that are able to produce glucoses, okay, from carbon dioxide and water. Remember the process of photosynthesis, which is water plus carbon dioxide, okay, and with the light energy or photo, then it will produce the glucose plus oxygen. What? So this is the process of photosynthesis. This is the food. This is the food that is produced by this photosynthesis process. Okay, so this is happening, this process happening in the organelle is called chloroplast. So only organism that have chloroplast able to produce the food, which is algae and plant. Algae also have cell wall, just like plant, they have cell wall. Some algae actually have flagella. So this flagella is actually kind of animal characteristic, right? So that's the reason why, you know, when we talk about protists, okay, so protists is a group organism that cannot be really tell whether it is animal or plant, because they have both characteristic of plants and animal. So they usually divide it into algae and protozoa. Algae is a group of protists that have more plant characteristic. The protozoa is a group of protists that have more animal characteristic. Again, algae, mostly they are free living. They are free living in the fresh water or maybe ocean water. They call as a plankton, okay? Because they are plant, they also call as phytoplankton. Okay, phytoplankton is a group of algae. They are floating in the water. Okay, so this is a group of algae that may be causing disease to human. And again, mostly they are what we call the opportunistic pathogen. They can cause disease when they enter into our body by accident. Okay, like for example, if we drink polluted water with algae. Okay, this is the classification of algae. There are several class. Iguanophyta, Pyrophyta, Chrysophyta, Pyophyta, Rhodophyta, and Chlorophyta. This is green algae, this is red algae, brown algae, this is euglenic algae, okay? This is dinoflagellate. So this is the organization, many of them unicellular. So for the euglenic or Euglenophyta, many of them one cell, okay, with flagella. Also, of course, it has chloroplast in it. Pyrophyta, many of them unicellular, and also have flagella for movement. Okay. Chrysophyta, many of them unicellular, but some of them colony, yeah, filamentous colony that make a long filament. Pyophyta mostly multicellular, and you can see them usually on the ocean, you know, like kelp and etc. So this is mostly macroalgae. Okay, it's a big algae. Rhodophyta is the same, many of them multicellular. It is this red algae that they can use to make agar, okay, for food. Okay, and then Chlorophyta, some of them unicellular, some of them filamentous or colony, and some of them multicellular. Okay. Protozoa, again, this one's gonna be the protist that has more animal characteristic, therefore many of them are heterotrophic organism. So it means that they have to get the nutrients from other organism. Okay, some of them will be parasite because they are heterotrophic. Many of them is actually free living. Protozoa, they actually classified based on their motility advantages, whether they have flagella. If they have flagella, then it's going to be grouped in one division. Whether they have cilia for movement or whether they have pseudopods for movement. Okay, so they're going to be classified into these different type of locomotion appendages, okay, locomotor appendages. We will actually learn more in chapter 23, yeah, about algae and also protozoa. For the identification, okay, it's gonna be based on the shape, the size of the cell, type and number of locomotor structure, okay, like how many flagellae, whether they have cilia as locomotor appendages, okay, number of nucleus for samples, okay, and then presence of special organelles under cell, or maybe the ability to produce what we call the cyst. Okay, cyst is a structure that protects the animal. Okay, so protect the animal inside the cyst. Especially it is made when the environment is not favorable for them. Okay, these are example of some pathogenic protozoa. Okay, again, we're gonna learn them or discuss them more in chapter 23 later. This is the first genus. It's called the Trypanosoma. They usually, okay, destroy the red blood cell. Okay, so they kill or destroy or eat the red blood cell. That's the reason why their primary disease or symptom or sign of this disease are anemia. Okay, because what? Because the red blood cells are being destroyed by this protozoa, the Trypanosoma. There are two main Trypanosoma that actually separated in two different continent. Yeah, the first one is called the Trypanosoma brucei. This is in Africa, causing disease called the African sleeping sickness. And this is anemia, type of anemia. The second one is called the Trypanosoma cruzi. This is in American continent, South America. So it's called, the disease called the Saga disease. And they usually need animal that is called as a factors. So the factor is mostly the type of insects. Okay, for example, for this Trypanosoma cruzi, the factor is called the kissing bugs. Okay, so this is the kissing bug, the factor. Why is called kissing bug? Because this bug is like to find the food around our mouth, especially when we sleep and we produce the drool. And this is the place where this animal like to absorb that. And sometimes they can bite our lips and then transfer this Trypanosoma into our blood. And then finally, the Trypanosoma over here live inside our blood and can destroy the red blood cell. Okay, so again, it is transferred by blood-sucking factor, like these kissing bugs. Okay, the second example of protozoa that can cause disease to human is called the ant amoeba. Okay, this is usually live in water. If we drink contaminated water with this ant amoeba, that it can cause disease called the ant amoeba histolytica. So this is in the GI tract. So this is amoebic dysentery. Okay, so this is a stomach ache problem. Which is gastrointestinal disturbances. They can also enter into our blood system and then deliver into other organ like liver, lungs, or skin. So they can cause also some infection in these organs. Okay, I think we're done with the protists. Then we will meet again on the last lecture, which is helminths or parasitic worm. Okay, I see you later then. Bye.